So hello, my name is Daniel Moneta. I'm CMO and VP Corporate Development for MMB Networks, and also the Marketing Work Group Chair and Board Member for the Zigbee Alliance. And I'm here with Peter Duine, Product Manager for Signify.
Thank you for having me here.
Thank you. So Signify has been a long-time Zigbee Alliance member, board member, contributor to a lot of the standards, and seems to have used Zigbee as the core of your connectivity strategy. Can you talk a bit about the benefits that you've seen from the technology in itself and why Signify chose that technology?
Yeah, the technology itself provides a means to come into every corner of a building and operate thousands of lights into a network to organize properly this automation that I described. That technology is also important because it provides the ecosystem, for instance, with switches using the Zigbee Green Power application protocol. So that has been very important for us. But perhaps overriding importance was that there is a Zigbee Alliance, a committee that helps and that organizes and orchestrates to improve the technology into the next level, and the standard keeps on evolving. We benefit from it because we cannot organize it on our own. And of course, we play our part there and provide use cases that can then be organized through the technology. So that has been important for us, and definitely that collaboration between a standardization authority and a business has been healthy already many, many years for us. In the lighting industry, actually, a lot of the work is done around standards. And so perhaps much to the benefit of the situation in smart cities or in smart homes, where there is a little bit of a wild west of technologies, lighting always drives towards standardization.
But that's interesting because, you know, I was going to say a company like Signify or before as a part of Philips, you know, large companies like that tend to be able to, if they want, create proprietary solutions, sort of push that on the market, require people to work with them. But, you know, quite early on, you were very involved in the Alliance. So, you know, can you speak to you touched on it a little bit, but can you speak to the benefits of being part of that standards process and being as involved as you are in it? You know, even considering, you know, you're in a room with potential competitors as
sure.
well.
Yeah, it eventually boils down to choice, right? The customers that I serve are professional lighting equipment manufacturers, and they look to Signify as a component supplier, and they trust and they work with us on a daily basis. But eventually they need choice. They need to say, well, this time I do my business with Signify, but in another case I want to have a choice to have an option to go to an alternative vendor.
Sure.
And that's baked into our industry. There's no way to run from it. We cannot hide from it. And for that reason, we provide the standards and we drive the standards in order for our customers to really lean into it and drive the technology, because if we would provide them a proprietary solution, they would probably be okay to organize perhaps a little business for us, mm-hmm. but not be the multipliers for us and really lean into it and make benefit of it, because they know that today they use Signify, but maybe tomorrow they might use another component vendor to organize the use case.
That makes sense. I think sometimes people see, you know, using a standard as somehow giving up on their ability to create value, but I know Signify has always seen, you know, their value really being above that communications
exactly.
layer and the value add on top of it. Can you talk about how, you know, working with a sort of standard as a baseline allows you to spend your time on the value and what that value is?
Yeah, to simplify the system, for instance, in the installation, right? If we use the standard building blocks, the way it's currently set up within Zigbee, you can still have choices of mm-hmm. how to do the commissioning, right? That's still, there's choices available.
Yeah.
And definitely we're investigating now to use, for instance, multi-protocol approach there, where perhaps in some cases a Bluetooth peer-to-peer direct link would provide benefits, where in other situations a Zigbee mesh will provide the best way forward.
Sure.
And in that way, we can differentiate on our technology, still using the standards compared to our competitors.
In passing, you mentioned one feature, which was green power, which is a feature unique to Zigbee. Are there other key features of the Zigbee technology that you found to be help you have a competitive edge or create new use cases and enable new applications that you weren't able to before?
Yeah, well, it's always the meshing quality, right? Yeah. And the ability to provide network, secure network and stable network with a multitude of nodes. I already mentioned that lighting, professional lighting in an office or a hospital or a school usually consists easily of 1,000 devices, right? That's an easy, that's a kind of common situation. And in these large-scale installations, having the ability to properly organize groups and make it simple and reliable is definitely something that we benefit from the Zigbee stack, from the Zigbee technology, that allows us to differentiate over our competitors.
So how important is Zigbee certification to Signify?
Yeah, it's going to be more and more important. In the early days, perhaps we could organize ourselves a little bit independent from doing certification, but definitely we decided going forward that we need it. And we see the benefits of it. By all means, we see the benefits of it. So definitely the products that we are working on today, I mentioned the multi-protocol products, will be looking for Zigbee certification going forward.